Howdy. Welcome back to another Chem Informatic lecture. This is going to be a continuation on from the Jupyter Notebook start and the RDKit molecule properties. In today's lecture, we're going to be going through the cannabis sativa list. These are all the chemicals inside of cannabis. And we're just going to use the RDKit descriptors from last lecture and kind of just analyze some unique things about cannabis maybe that we didn't know before. So here you can kind of see that I call the global chem, build the network, and then get the list of cannabis sativa smoth. So if I look here between the list of the 100 things inside of cannabis, you can see here the list of smiles that I'm fetching. So we want to analyze this list and see certain properties about cannabis sativa that we might have not seen before. So from the last lecture, we had those RDKit descriptors, if you remember. So here I'm going to take those RDKit descriptors. Each molecule will have this property, and then we'll append that property to a list. And so we'll use this to kind of capture, like, okay, so what is the distribution of the amount of rings inside of cannabis? Like, how many rings does cannabis like to be at? Or how many log p values they are, and see if we can notice any trends. So the next thing is to plot the distribution of the numbers. And what's going on here is that we want to get an idea of where the numbers like to lie. And this allows us to evaluate trends in the data. So to do this, we'll be using Plotly, and I've added the Plotly template code below in the description. In the Plotly code, you'll see this label, which means which label or which property that we're trying to look at. So let's look at something simple, like molecular weight. So if we take the distribution here, you can kind of see these are the values of like how likely that the number kind of lies there, and the higher that this y-axis is, the more likely that the number is tending to be there. And if you look at our molecular weight, which is measured in grams per mole, you'll see that a lot of the molecules are tending to lie between 448-ish grams per mole, which makes sense if you analyze like any of those terpene structures. They have those long alkyl groups, but they're still not as complex. The max size of a molecular weight seems to go down to 6,134 grams per mole, which is a pretty big compound. So this might be some sort of protein or some sort of enzyme, or a very long peptide sequence in there that's kind of causing that molecular weight. So let's look at some other things that could be here. So the log p value, so if you remember your partition coefficient, and this is like how many of those compounds would like to be in the non-polar layer versus the polar layer. So if we look at the log p values, you'll see this kind of distribution around negative log p and positive log p. The negative log p meaning that it's hydrophilic, it likes the water in the aqueous phase, whereas the positive value means lipophilic, something that likes the organic salt more. And you can kind of see this distribution where the, you know, a lot of those terpene compounds tend to like to be in the organic layer. And then there are alcohols and steroids in there that could be perhaps more water soluble, which I've noticed in that set. As you go down fully, the biggest negative log p value is starting to get to around negative 41, which is pretty high. So it really, really likes just the water layer. And that could be attributed to many of those sugars, perhaps. So let's look at something a little bit more interesting, maybe the number of rings inside of each set. So here we can kind of see the number of rings in the distribution. So these, here we can kind of see, okay, so a lot of the systems have one ring or around two rings in there. But most of the time there isn't like a lot of rings inside of cannabis sativa. Nothing as big as like 60 or 80. Although something must be flagging this to get the distribution this high. So there must be maybe like a peptide in there that's the same size, or it's a really big peptide and has like a lot of tyrosines or something on it. That's this video of just analyzing cannabis sativa and getting an idea of how to use these descriptors and analyzing a list of smiles to infer something about that data set. I hope that you guys can play around with it. Please like, subscribe to the video, and I'll see you guys in the next lecture. Thank you.